Hello, dear girls and boys, and very, very warm good afternoon to all of you. And yes, I can see Rishabh, Guru, Deepak, Amol. So, good noon to all of you. And yes, Guru, after a long time, I can see you right in time. So, I'm quite glad to see that. And Rishabh and Deepak again, thank you very much for joining. They are very loyal to both of my classes, right? But Rishabh, here you won't get Ashwini sir, as far as I know, okay? Ashwini sir is available only in class 12th. Fine. So let's begin with, I hope all your preparations are going well. I know in this batch also there are some those who are still in 11th only, but there are some of 12th, and there are some who have taken a break after their 12th break, 12th examination. So see, similarly, the preparation will also change. So as in every now and then I say keep solving the questions, especially Rishabh and Deepak. This is very, very mandatory for you to solve questions, okay? Because you have already gone through the subject. I think I'm not mistaken, Deepak, right? You have also given your 12th board, because for Rishabh I remember. So if not, the thing is, please solve the question. For you people, solving more question will be more helpful, okay? So every day make it a routine that whatever time you are spending on physics or chemistry, double the time you have to spend. Now please don't tell me I just spent 15 minutes on chemistry and physics, so I'll just spend half an hour for bio. That won't work. Okay, thank you, Deepak. So I'm very correct in my memory. So solving question is important. So now I'll tell you one thing. If every day you are reading bio for, say, for example, 2 hours or 3 hours, okay? So in that 2 hours of reading, 1 hour should be dedicated completely to question solving. Is that clear to you? It should be dedicated completely to question solving, and I'm talking only about bio, not 1 hour collective for all subjects, okay? And then only you will come to know whether you have known the topic or not, and you will also be your own teacher, like which questions are asked frequently in exams, okay? So that is mandatory. I think Rishabh Guru is trying to ask you something. I don't know what exactly. So let's move ahead. So in moving ahead, on your screen is the recap of the previous class, what we have discussed in the previous classes. So the we have discussed the three parts, the root, stem and the leaves, okay? So their modification and all that we have studied, and based on these you were given 10 questions, the CPP questions, in which where most of you have gone, this was the question, the very first question: in dicotyledonous plant, elongation of radical leads to the formation of A, primary root, B, secondary root, C, tertiary root, and D, main stem, okay? So the answer is actually A, primary root, but most of you have opted for C, tertiary root, okay? So it won't be, because it is asking directly from radical. So directly from radical, it is the primary root only which will arise, okay? Then you will have the secondary root, in that you may have the tertiary root, okay? So primary is always the main axis, okay? Yes, Guru, the answer is A. So now let's move ahead, and moving ahead in today's class. And moving ahead in today's class, we have this types of inflorescence. Okay, inflorescence is the arrangement of flowers over the axis. Phool kaise arrange hai? Now, sometimes when in my childhood, when I was there, I would be like, okay, I know, haan, theek hai, this is a flower. What will I do by knowing how it is arranged, why it is arranged? But this how and why answer I have already given in the last class, why you need to study morphology, okay? So the same thing. So we will be discussing the arrangement of the flowers first, and then flowers in detail, the structure of the flower, and the four whorls, okay? Calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. These are the four whorls of the flower that we will be discussing in detail. So now let's begin. So to begin with, we have the inflorescence. So inflorescence is nothing but the arrangement of flowers on the floral axis. See, flowers. That means it is talking about more than one flower. So if you have a cluster of flowers, how it is arranged on the main axis, that is known as inflorescence. And the main types are racemos and cymos. Obviously, there are some special types, and yes, there is a type that is known as solitary. Solitary. So, in case of solitary, actually, as the name suggests, you have a single flower. Okay. But yes, in inflorescence, we have seen it's a cluster of flower, but still there is a single flower and its arrangement on the main axis is there. So, that also is included under inflorescence. Okay. So, in case of solitary, you can either have a terminal flower or you can have an axial flower. Okay. Terminal means the main axis terminates at the flower. Okay, so if this is the axis, it will end in a flower. This should not be, wait, the main axis terminates in the flower. So that was the main axis and that is terminating in a flower. So this is terminal. Okay, in case of axial, the flowers are borne laterally, but all of them will have one flower each. Okay, so this is axillary. This kind of is found in case of hibiscus. Okay, so this is solitary. Okay, thank you Rishabh and Guru. So now we are moving to the this type studies. What is racemos, what is cymos, and what are their types? Okay, so racemos can be simple or compound, and now on your screen it is simple. So in case of racemos, what happens is in racemos it actually has a terminal bud, okay, and which will grow and give rise to the flowers. It has a terminal bud and it will give rise to flowers lateral or axillary. So this is kind of indefinite. The flowers can keep on coming on the main stem. That is called racemos type of inflorescence. Okay, racemos type of inflorescence. In that we have again simple and compound. Under simple, the first one is raceme. That is a typical raceme. So in this case, what will happen if this is the main axis? Okay, so you will have flowers arranged in alternate way. Okay, so this is the simplest type of racemos. Okay, and in this the flowers are stalked. As you can see here, you have the stalk also. This is simple raceme, and in see there are two kinds of arrangement in this also. One is acropetal, other one is centripetal. Acropetal succession is in which the youngest flower will be at the top, okay, and at the bottom will be the older one. So yahan pe sabse pehla wala, yahan dusra wala, yahan teesra wala, yahan chautha wala, and then this is the most new one. So this is called acropetal succession. In case of centripetal succession, the youngest flower will be in the center followed by the older ones. So the more old it will be more towards the periphery. So that is called centripetal arrangement. Acropetal, youngest at the top. So in case of a typical racemos type, it is acropetal succession. Okay, and this kind of typical raceme is found in case of mustard or radish. Okay. Then we have the another type, that is spike. Ab spike kya hai? So in case of spike, remember here I said you they have stalk. You remove this stalk, it will become spike raceme. Okay, so this is the main axis again. The flowers will not have a stalk. So these are the flowers. Okay, this is spiked raceme. Okay, and in this also it is arranged in the way of acropetal succession. The flowers are arranged in as in case of acropetal succession only, and the best example for this is bottle brush. Have you seen bottle brush? Or amaranthus also is an example of bottle brush. Next is catkin. Okay, catkin is actually a pendulous inflorescence. Pendulous matlab ye ulta hoga. See here, this is the base and this is the top. In case of catkin, it will be the other way round. Theek hai? And their flowers will be arranged. So this is generally found hanging in case of plants. And this is the arrangement of the flowers. Theek hai? This is catkin, and this kind of inflorescence is found in case of mulberry. Okay, now we are into spadix. Spadix kya hai? In this, the entire inflorescence where flowers, it is covered with a amaranthus. You have seen amaranthus, we all must have seen. Okay, how many of you have not seen amaranthus? Anyways, we were at spadix. So spadix, which is there. Okay, I was talking about, see, bottle brush is nothing but a red color flower, and it is generally planted in or in the streets or like a decorative plant, and because it looks like a bottle brush cleaner. Okay, you have the rod and like this bristles, you have the flower also looks like the same, but it is red in color, that is more beautiful. Okay, now we are at spadix. So spadix, they have a large showy bract. Okay, and this kind of inflorescence, you can understand this by like in case of banana. Okay, you will find spadix inflorescence. So they have a large showy bract, and the bract will cover the flowers. Inside that you will have the androecium and gyne. School ke entrance mein laga rehta hai. Sahi hai. So that means you have an eye of observation, like observer. Or had your teacher told you this is this plant? Because yes, around us there are many plants. Most of the examples that we give, it's already there or you must have seen. But only thing is that we do not know the name. Okay, probably you know the name, but the vernacular name, jo local name hai, wo humko yaad rehta hai. But the English name, or specifically if it goes to scientific name, to wo to pura swap ho jata hai, right? So this spadix arrangement is found in case of, even in maize it is found. Maize mein it is found only in female flowers. Then you have the banana, as I said. Okay, so these are the examples. Like in colocasia also the spadix is found. Now we have corymb and umbel. So corymb and umbel, actually they look like the same. Okay, but there is a difference, basic difference between them. In case of corymb, actually this, if this is the main axis, okay, so the flower will be at the same level, but they will come from the base. So they will have a variable length of stalk. Okay, variable length of stalk hai wahan pe, and this is the arrangement of the flower. So this is corymb inflorescence. Whereas in case of umbel, what will happen? Umbel mein kya hoga? It is umbrella like. So if this is the stalk, from here all of them will come, and the stalk or the pedicel is greatly reduced, and they all are of similar size. As to here, the way I have drawn, it looks more or less. Oh, your principal sir told you. So you had a good connectivity with your principal, Deepak. So this is umbel arrangement, and in case of umbel, you will find the bracts also. Okay, so that is corymb and this is umbel. So if the difference again here is, in case of corymb, it, though it is acropetal, kya hai, acropetal hi hai. This is the young one and then these are the older ones, but from the top when it is looked upon, it looks like centripetal. ठीक है, बट इन केस ऑफ अम्बेल इट इज सेंट्रीपेटल प्रॉपरली द अरेंजमेंट ऑफ फ्लावर. ओके, सो दैट इज अम्बेल. एंड अम्बेल काइंड ऑफ दिस इज फाउंड इन ब्राह्मी सेंटेला एशियाटिका. ओके, द वर्नैक्युलर नेम इज ब्राह्मी. ओके, एंड दिस वन इज फाउंड इन केस ऑफ कैंडी टफ. Okay, so these are the simple type of racemes. Now if we move to the capitulum, capitulum is disc kind of arrangement. Theek hai, capitulum is disc kind of arrangement. So in this case what will happen, you will have a disc like in case of sunflower. And here you have the ray florets. So there are two types of florets. This is ray, and on the disc again we have the florets, that is disc florets. Okay. So these are disc florets. Florets means the small flowers. Okay. These are disc florets. Okay. And here you have involucre of bracts. Here also you have bracts. These are bracts. Okay, so see in this case what happens is you have a disc kind of a thing on which the flowers are worn. Okay, so that is why this arrangement is known as capitulum. ठीक है, and this kind of a disc is found in case of sunflower, marigold, all that. Okay, so these are the different types of simple floral arrangements. Now let's move into the next part. Inflorescence in coriander we will come, it's a different one, Deepak. Okay, so now we are into compound racemes. So that in compound we have the panicle. See, compound or simple raceme mein the difference, basic difference is simple is in the stalk and then you have the flowers. Compound में you will have branches. Okay, so that's why it is compound spike, compound spadix, compound corym, compound umbel, compound capitulum. So सारा जो हमने रेसिम में पढ़ा उसके आगे आगे compound prefix डाल दिया है हमने, ठीक है. So in this case the only difference is that you will have more branches in that. Like in case of panicle, what will happen? The main stem will have branches. Okay. And on that branches you will have lateral branches. Ye lateral branches aa gaya. In lateral branches now you will have the raceme inflorescence. Theek hai, so this is actually panicle kind of arrangement. Okay, example is yucca plant. Now in case of compound spike. Okay, so what was spike that we discussed? In spike there was no stalk, remember. So here compound spike means arrangement will be spiked only, but you will have branches. Okay, so in that case it will become like in case of grasses we see. Okay, so you have this, this is the branches and here you will have the spikes. So these are the flowers, okay, not the leaves the way I'm drawing. So this will be called as compound spike and this is found in case of grasses. Now compound spadix. Okay, so compound spadix, spadix kya tha, you had a showy bract in that compound spadix mein kya hoga, it will be the entire inflorescence jo bhi hai it will be covered with the help of the bract, and this is found in case of coconut. Okay, so whole of the inflorescence is actually covered with the bract. Actually I didn't like the way I wrote, so there were some spikes, no. Which one you are talking about is for decoration, Deepak? Now we are into compound corym and compound umbel. So cauliflower which you are saying, Deepak, it is compound corym. Okay. So compound corym mein kya hoga? As we have discussed, if the flower should come on the same margin, right? So what, this is the compound corym structure. And yes, the example for compound corym is cauliflower. Okay, then we have compound umbel. So compound umbel mein bhi kya hoga, the same thing like in case of umbel, from one position there were more flowers, so you have branching, and again in that branching you have the flowers from one position only. So this is compound umbel, and compound umbel is found in case of coriander. Okay, coriander ho gaya, or you talk about fennel, okay, or carrot, they will be compound umbel. Theek hai, clear Deepak? So that's not simple umbel, it is compound umbel. But yes, if it is not given compound umbel, simple umbel hai and then rest of things are different thing, then yes you can opt. But if compound umbel and umbel are given, it should be compound umbel. Is that clear? Okay, so this was for this and this was for coriander, and next, yeah, compound capitulum. So again, that disc, you will have multiple discs, okay, in case of compound capitulum. Now we will move into the next part, that is the cymose type of inflorescence. So cymose is actually definite, at the terminal there will be flower, so it can be uniperous, biperous or multiperous. Okay, so in case of uniperous, again in case of uniperous, it is divided into two types, that is scorpioid and helicoid. What are they? See, I said you will have a terminal flower in this case. So this has grown and this has a flower. But when the flower comes and when the lateral bud comes, it slightly pushes the main stem. So because of that, what will happen? It will get a zigzag appearance. Okay, this is called scorpioid. This we are talking in uniperous. Okay, then in uniperous only, see here it is alternate, lateral is coming alternately, but if it doesn't comes alternately, if it comes like this, it is called helicoid. Helicoid is found in begonia. Scorpioid in freesia. Okay, so these are the two types of uniperous cymose inflorescence. So cymose is definite, you can see at the end only the flower comes. In case of racemose, terminal flower was not there. Then we have biperous. So in biperous, what will happen? See, we know that we need a terminal flower. So here I have the terminal flower. Now what will happen, from its base two branches will come, and again it will have a flower, then again there will be two branches, like that it will go multiple number of times, making it like a bushy appearance. Okay, gucche jaisa ho jayega. And this kind of, this is found in ixora. Ixora is a very common decorative plant. Okay, and it is ixora only, wo like some people, they take the florets and if you suck the basal part of that, it appears to be sweet. That's very common practice that students do as a child. Okay, even I have done. So that's why I have given the example of ixora. Then in jasmine also you find this kind of a biperous arrangement. Then in multiperous, the difference between multiperous and biperous is that here from the base, see, two branches have arisen. From here more than two will come. Okay, so more than two will come, they will have their own flowers, then from there also you will have more than two. Okay, That only I guess, Deepak. Neon orange color. Not a tree. The flower is, I think, that color. Okay. So you can see from the base you have the more than 2 is coming out. So that is the multiparous kind of arrangement. Clear? So that is, these are the different types of cymose inflorescence. And this kind of a multiparous inflorescence is found in calotropis. Clear? What happened, Deepak? Why question mark? Then we have 3 special types, that is Hypanthodium, Cyathium and Verticillester. Okay? So, ab ye sab kya hai? In this we do not have a simple structure, no? Ek stalk, pedicel hai aur phool hai, nahi, nature hai, so there has to be some complexity. So, in case of Hypanthodium, what happens? The entire thing, okay? It is the main axis itself becomes swollen and the flower is present inside that, and at the top they will have a small opening that is called ostea. Okay. So the main axis gets transformed into a fleshy stalk. Okay. So this is the condition. This what I am drawing, this is the case of fig. So here you will have the ostium or the osteole. Okay. And if we look into the inside part of this, so you have this, and here only the flowers are born. And inside this you will have both male and female flowers. So male flowers are generally present towards the ostea or ostium. Female flowers are present in the base, and in between we have the neutral flowers. Okay. Yes, ficus is even in fig. This is the diagram for a fig. In Hypanthodium, you will have even ficus religiosa, that is people. Okay, even the banyan tree that comes under Hypanthodium inflorescence only. Then in case of Cyathium, it is found in Euphorbia. Okay, it is a so many of the cymose get fused to form this Euphorbia. Yes, it is pollinated by gall wasp, and that's why here the neutral flowers are also known as gall flowers. Okay, because the insect larvae is present in that. See, the flower is closed, so how come it will be pollinated? Because before the flower itself, there will be the larva will be there. Then it ruptures, and once it comes out, it will pollinate, and then it will come out of the flower. That's why the fig tree shows a very high degree of specificity towards its pollinator. If pollinator is not there, the flowers will fail to fertilize, or the pollen will fail to fertilize the ovum. Now let's come back to Cyathium. So in case of Cyathium, fusion of the florets takes place. Okay, so this you have the bract. Okay, and then the ovary which is there, gets fused to form one single one, and it will come out of this, and then you have multiple stamens in this case. Okay. This is the case of Euphorbia. Okay. Where is the R? Euphorbia. Now Verticillester, the most common example is Osimum sanctum, that is the tulsi. So if you have seen the tulsi floret, you can easily imagine what I am talking about. So this is your Hypanthodium. Okay, this was Cyathium, and now what I am going to draw is Verticillester. So if this is the stem, okay, not for tulsi, for others. So this is the opposite leaves, and here only these are the bracts. Okay, and in the bracts you will find the flowers. Okay, and it will be arranged all around that axis. Similarly, here also you have the bracts and then the flowers. Okay, so that is Verticillester kind of arrangement. Yes, in case of Salvia family also you find Verticillester kind of arrangement. Okay, now On your screen is the question of previous class, which I have asked, what is the region where the leaves are borne on the stem are called? So that is, the answer is A, nodes, and the correct answer was given by, first given by Shabdaini. So a big round of applause for her, but I think she is not there as of now today. So if we meet her in the next class, you may inform her, and to her the free atom session will be credited by the end of this class. And now on your screen will be the today's contest question. So today's contest question is, Capitulum inflorescence is found in A, cauliflower, B, colocasia, C, marigold, and D, coconut. So I have just said this, you need to simply answer. It's very, very, very simple. Okay, Deepak and Rishabh, you have given the answer. Capitulum inflorescence is found in A, cauliflower, B, colocasia, C, marigold, D, coconut. Question will go off your screen. I'll be coming back on your screen, and with this we are into the next topic. So in the first part we have discussed the different types of inflorescence, the racemose and the cymose and their variety. Now on your screen is the diagram or the structure of a sweet simple flower. To understand this, we just need to understand what we are going to, and you have been like reading the different parts of flower, okay. So Guru, are you there? I can't see any of your comments. Have you answered the contest question, or you just came to say hi? Is he there? So now here, in this case, if you see the four whorls of flower which I was talking about, that is corolla. Here you have the corolla, calyx, then you have this androecium and gynoecium. Okay. The male reproductive part, the female reproductive part, the petal and the sepal, these are called the four whorls of the plant, okay. And now if in the plant, if both androecium and gynoecium is present, that is called as unisexual or bisexual. Answer it. If both male and female parts are present in the same flower. Meanwhile, I'll explain this. So the gynoecium, which is there, it is divided into three parts. This is the stigma, then this is the style, the tube like structure, and the lower swollen structure, that is called ovary. And here you have the enlarged view of ovary. Inside the ovary we have the ovules, okay, to which actually the pollen needs to go. Then we have the corolla and calyx. As such, they do not participate directly in the process of reproduction. So flower is what? It is the reproductive part of the plant, okay. Many people get confused when we talk about reproductive part. So yes Guru, I can see you are there, so I am very glad. So in this case, reproductive part, many of people feel that because we can propagate plants through stem, leaf or roots also. So because of that reproductive part, how come it will be flower, okay. But when we talk about reproductive flower, we talk about the part where meiosis will take place, like during gamete formation, where you have fertilization, okay. So that will be called as the reproductive part, and that is the reason why we refer flower as the reproductive part of the plant, okay. Yes, in case of monoecious, you will have the same, okay. Now here, this was there, and then androecium, if you see, you have the anther, and then you have the filament or the stalk to which it is attached to the plant, okay. And here, inside the anther, you have the microsporangium, or inside that, you will have the pollens, which are required to fertilize the egg in the inside the ovule, okay. So these are the things, and then this is the, from where all the floral parts are coming, that is floral axis. Then you have the articulation, and then below this is the pedicel or the stalk, okay. Now let's look into them one by one. Now here again the same thing is said, okay. So you, they are arranged, the four whorls are arranged on a solen stalk called the pedicel that we have seen, and the four whorls are calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium that we will be discussing now in detail. Now when flower has both androecium and gynoecium, the flower is called bisexual, okay. That means both the sexes are present, or monoecious. Monoecious means marriage. They are living inside the same house. Dioecious is divorced, so they needs to be separated, and that condition is known as unisexual. So got your answer, all of you? Rishabh, Deepak, now when a flower can be divided into two rays, so now these are the terms you need to remember: actinomorphic and zygomorphic. Okay, so when the flower has a radial symmetry, if the, it can be divided along any radii, it can be divided into two equal halves, that is called radial symmetry, and that kind of a symmetry is found in mustard, datura and chili. Okay, so these are the examples you need to remember. Okay, then when flowers can be divided into two similar parts only along one axis like V, bilateral symmetry, that is called zygomorphic flower, and that is found in pea, gulmohar, keshia. Pea flower, have you all seen the standard wings and the keel? If not, maybe in coming classes, yes, while discussing Fabaceae family, we will talk about that and I'll show you the pictures or images of that. And when these appendages, the floral calyx, corolla, are present in the multiples of 3, 4, 5, it will be trimerous, tetramerous or pentamerous. The flower which has bracts, bracts are nothing but reduced leaves, okay. So at the base of the flower we find the bracts, that is, they are, will be known as bracteates, and where the bracts are absent, that they are called as ebracteate. So these are the terms you need to remember: just actinomorphic, zygomorphic, then bracteates, ebracteates. Simple, bracteate means bract present, ebracteate, bract absent. Okay, now position of the ovary. So based on the position of the ovary, the flower can be divided into hypogynous flower, perigynous flower or epigynous flower. So mostly the confusion where lies is in this word hypogynous, okay, but where it is hypogynous, it is superior. Hypogynous means all the floral parts are coming from the base of the ovary, hypogynous, below the gynoecium. Gynoecium is not below, okay, don't get confused because of the name. So below the ovary all the floral parts are coming, okay, sigma style ovary, and from here only you will have the attachment for the stamens, then you have the corolla, then you have the calyx. So that kind of a condition is known as hypogynous or superior ovary. Ovary is the king, sitting above all the floral parts, okay. So that kind of a thing is found in mustard, brinjal and China rose. Now, in case of perigynous flower, if the gynoecium is situated in the center, see here, this is neither completely above this axis nor completely below. Position of ovary is in the center, and from here the floral parts are coming, the anther, the corolla, the calyx, okay. So this kind of a flower is known as perigynous flower or half inferior, okay. Half inferior word is also used for this kind of flower, and this is found in case of plum, rose, peach, okay, they have perigynous flower. In case of epigynous, you can see this is the ovary and all the floral structures are coming above it, okay. This is the androecium, corolla, calyx. So this kind of a flower is known as epigynous flower or inferior ovary, okay. And this is found in case of guava and cucumber. These are the example. Okay, once it will work, Deepak, you can get connected. So this is the position on the basis of position of ovary. The flower is divided into three types: hypogynous, perigynous, epigynous. Hypogynous means superior ovary, perigynous means half inferior, and epigynous means inferior ovary. Okay. So remember, the hypo and epi words are used for the floral parts and not for the ovary. Hypo means floral parts are coming from below, so it is superior, because that is where generally people get confused or students get confused, hypo and epi, because epi means top. So yes, it is top, but not for ovary, but for the floral structure. Okay, clear? Now we are into the calyx. So calyx is the outermost whorl of the flower, that is like sepals. They are also called sepals, and if the sepals are jointed, that will be called as gamosepalous, and if they are free, it is called polysepalous. Now here one thing you should remember, that gamo or syn, this is the word, syn means not S-I-N, S-Y-N, this is the word used for together. Okay, so if it is syn or gamo, that means it is fused. So if all the sepal are fused to form a cup kind of a shape, okay, then it is called gamosepalous. If the sepals are free, okay, like if this is the ovary, okay, you have the corolla, and below that only you have the sepals, the calyx. Okay, so if the calyx is free, this is called polysepalous. Okay, and function of sepal is it protects the flower in the bud stage. Okay, because once the flower blooms, you will find it is remains covered with the green structure. Okay, and once it blooms, that green part comes down and the flower blooms, the corolla comes out of it. Okay, now corolla, the petals. So corolla consist of petals brightly colored to attract the pollination. Yes, that is the basic function of the corolla. Why they have brightly colored flowers? Because for the pollination. Okay, now in this case we have a different types of arrangement, that is called estivation. Okay, estivation is the arrangement of the whorls in a flower. So now if the petal, the corolla, is arranged end to end, see here there is no overlapping, end to end, like we play ringa ringa roses. Okay, end to end we hold the hand, that is called valvate estivation. In case of twisted, you can see one is inside the other, one end is out, one other end is in, again one end is out, other end is in, and this is in a particular direction. Okay, so this kind of estivation is known as twisted. But in case of imbricate, it is inside out, like see here both of them are out, here both of them are in. Okay, and now here it is in, here it is in. So you cannot tell the direction in which the twist is there. Okay, when you cannot tell the direction in which the twist is there, then it is called imbricate. Okay, and then we have the valvate, or sorry, the vexillary. Vexillary, this kind of an arrangement is found in case of pea or beans. What will happen, this is the outermost and the largest leaf, this is called the standard petal, these are called the wings, and this is called the keel. Okay, and here you can see there is no perfect arrangement. Okay, so the difference is valvate is the most basic, arranged end to end, no twisting. If it is twisted in one particular direction, it is twisted. If you cannot identify the twisting direction, then it will be imbricate. And if it is like this, okay, one covering the other, then covering the third one, that is called vexillary. Okay, so these are, and if you take the example, valvate is found in case of calotropis. Okay, twisted is found in case of China rose, imbricate, gulmohar, or even acacia, and this I already said, pea and bean. So these are the examples. So when you come across these flowers, you can notice on your own also, these are very common examples. Okay, now we are at, yes, in case of cotton also we have the twisted cotton or lady's finger, there also we have the twisted kind of estivation, Deepak. Okay, and vexillary is also known as papilionaceous. Papilionaceous, yes, That is the pronunciation for vexillary also. Now, androecium. So, androecium, as we have seen, you will have a filament and then you have the anther. Okay, so anther and filament, that forms the androecium or the stamen, all the male reproductive part of the plant. Okay, and in case of this, if the stamen is sterile, these are the terms which you need to remember. Sterile stamen is known as staminoid. Okay, now in case of stamen also, if it is free, okay, or if it is attached to the petals, then it is called epipetalous. Epipetalous, then there is a word called epiphyllous. Epiphyllous. So, this means in this case, in case of epipetalous, the stamen is attached to the petals. In case of epiphyllous, it is attached to the perianth. Okay. Now, in this again, the stamen can be free, like if it is a flower, it can be free like this, or it can be jointed. So, if it is free, if the stamen is free, then it is called polyandrous. Poly means many, so that means it is free. So, polyandrous. If it is jointed or joined, then it can be either monoadelphous or diadelphous. Or it can be polyadelphous. Now, what are these? Monoadelphous means the stamens are jointed, the filaments will be jointed to form one cluster, that is monoadelphous. In case of diadelphous, you will have two clusters. This is one cluster and one will be separate. So, this is diadelphous. Polyadelphous, you will get multiple clusters, multiple stamens fused forming different clusters. Okay. So, that is called polyadelphous. Yes, this is found in case of pea. Did you give answer for this, Deepak Fabasi? So, this is in pea, this is in case of again China rose. Okay. So, China rose, if you will see, you will find it is attached and at the top only they are free, the anthers will be free. And then again in case of, in some flowers there is variation in length or filament of this, like in case of mustard and all. So, that is there. So, these are the terms you need to remember from androecium. Okay. Polyandrous, monoadelphous, diadelphous, polyadelphous, and examples are must. Okay. At least the examples which are there in your NCERT, that is a must to remember. Okay. Then we are into the gynoecium and we are running short of time already. So, gynoecium is actually stigma, style and ovary. This is the stigma, this is style and this is the ovary. Okay, stigma, style and ovary, that is the gynoecium or the ovary structure which we talk about. Okay, then in case of a flower, if more than one, this is also known as carpel. If more than one carpel is present, not capel, carpel. Okay, if it is free, then we have the term called apocarpus. If it is jointed, this is called syn. Remember, I talked about gamo or syn. So, syncarpus. In case of jointed, it will be syncarpus, carpus fused. This is found in case of tomato or mustard, like that. Okay, apocarpus is found in case of lotus. Okay. So, these are the terms you need to remember from the gynoecium, and now we are into the last part, that is the placentation. So, as of now you just remember these are the placentation. In the next class I will explain in detail with examples what is this. As of now you remember the arrangement of ovules within the ovary is known as placentation. Okay, ki ovules kaise arranged hai in an ovary, and it can be of different types, five different types. Marginal, if it is at the margin. Axial, if it is on the axis and septa is present, dividing the ovary into different chambers. Okay. Then parietal, if it is present at the margins, that is called parietal placentation. If it is in the center and there is no septum, then it is free central, beech mein hai. And if it is at the base, okay, single ovule is there at the base, that is called basal. Okay, in detail, like what are the examples? Only part I'm missing is the examples that we will discuss in the next class. And with this, we have come to the summary of the class. So in this class, what we have discussed, the different types of inflorescence, the flower, and the different voles of the flower in detail, and we have also discussed the different types of inflorescence, cymos, racemos, all that. And I hope you have understood what I was speaking and it was useful to you. If yes, please rate the video and do share it with your friends. And now thank you very much for joining Deepak and Rishabh and Guru for staying tuned till the end of the class, because when you people are there, I really feel good. Like, I feel like I am actually teaching. Otherwise, it's simply the camera. And now it is the CPP time. So on your screen, the CPP questions will pop up. Please solve the questions, because these questions are based on this topic only. So you can get a jazz. And I said you, Deepak and Rishabh, for you, it is mandatory to solve question every day. Okay. On this note, I take your leave. And next time on the same time, I'll be available with a different topic. Till then, passport users, start solving the questions. Good luck.